New evidence uncovered by Fox 2 reveals city leaders knew the Lindell Union Bridge was dangerous before a bridge wall fell and killed a woman last July. Fox Files investigator Chris Hayes has been following the story for months to find out what the city knew and when they knew it.
I requested these emails between city officials to see what they said about the Lindell and Union Bridge before and after last summer's fatal accident.
July 23, 2018, a woman driving on the Lindell and Union Bridge hits the sidewall and knocks a one-ton pylon onto Forest Park Parkway. It landed on Jan Teresi Mokwa, wife of former police chief Joe Mokwa. She died instantly. Fox 2 requested emails between city officials before and after that fatal crash. We found they were already concerned because of previous crashes, like this one that sent debris down on Forest Park Parkway. One email warning was just 3 months before July's fatal crash. It was on April 3, 2018, and it led the city's chief construction engineer to ask for action. The city engineer wrote in this email obtained by Fox 2, "It was hit again. Please make it safe." The city took limited action, placing barriers like this next to the railing over the Metrolink tracks, but nothing was done to the area involved in the fatal crash that killed Teresi Mokwa in July. After that fatal accident, St. Louis Director of Operations Todd Walterman wrote this email saying, "Bridge is safe. Accident report from police will come in a few months. This should shed a better light on events." Fox 2 got an exclusive look at that police report, and it confirms the concerns about those bridge walls, noting the pylon that fell was, quote, "not a fixed one, but a yielding one." I obtained the original plans from 1930, and they show the pylons rest on the bridge and are not bolted down. Those original plans also show the bridge was built as a roundabout, which would feature a garden in the center.
Traveling in a circle, you're not going to present the same danger to, hitting the railing.
Bill Hannigan lives nearby and says residents have warned the city for years about speeds here.
Today, the entire bridge is now lined with those protective barriers. Former police chief Joe Mokwa settled a lawsuit with the city over the crash that killed his wife. Those terms have never been made public. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.